First, test if this is real shungite. Metal is very conductive, but wood and plastic isn't. This is probably what some say is a lower quality of shungite, but it does look conductive. This one looks to be what they say is a better quality shungite. I have often seen people do the following test to prove shungite blocks or absorbs EMF. So you would think it does this here, right? The problem is that the test is misleading, because it's my hand that causes the reduction. So make sure you understand how EMF meters work first, before you believe a random stranger trying to sell you something with a fake test. Try to remember the values seen here. If shungite would absorb electric fields, then we should see a reduction in this body voltage test. This voltage measured on my body comes from the electric cables in this room. You don't measure this on your body in a field or a forest, so this is unnatural. I see no difference in body voltage with or without that stone. The values just fluctuate a little bit. I'm showing both hands so you can see that I hold them absolutely still in the exact same place to keep the values as stable as possible. It looks like shungite does not lower body voltage. I see no significant difference. Moving my hand further from the power strip, or closer to it, is what changes the values. Is shungite magnetic? The needle doesn't move. This one doesn't move it either. But a screwdriver with a magnetic tip is able to move the needle. This is a much stronger magnet. I wanted to know if this shungite would stick to a magnet or not. The pendant doesn't. And this rock also does not stick to the magnet. Try to remember the values on the meters. I don't see a noticeable change. Once again, I think it's just my hand that causes the noticeable change. This metal sheet has a noticeable effect though, on the EMF 390. On the cornet you can also see a dip on its histogram after I remove the metal sheet. Now a test to see if they can influence magnetic fields. There is no difference whatsoever. A very cheap multimeter can also be used to check for conductivity. You can't use a cheap voltmeter like this one for measuring body voltage though. It won't work. I added some info in the description about what to look for. Both pieces of shungite look conductive on this meter. Try to remember the values on the 2 meters on the right side. I see no noticeable difference. Now the left side. I cannot see a noticeable difference. I think you have noticed that the values go down when my hand comes in view. This is the only thing I noticed that influenced the values.